Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you about ureteral pelvic junction obstruction imaging, UPJ obstruction. Terminology: UPJ obstruction is the most common form of urinary tract obstruction in children. Most common sign symptom and clinically detected on fetal sonogram or MRI. Other signs symptoms in infants and children: urinary tract infection, intermittent abdominal pain, flank pain, or hematuria. In older children who present with symptomatic UPJ obstruction, crossing vessel is causative in 50%. DIEGL's apostrophe crisis, episodic abdominal pain, and UPJ obstruction. Demographic: male are 52 to 4 times more than female, left more than right, bilateral in 10 to 50%. Incident of 1/75 to 100,000 births. Imaging: mark hepatocalyptasis. Dilated calyces are relatively uniform in size and distribution, or connect centrally to disproportionately dilated renal pelvis, thin but otherwise intact renal parenchyma. Doppler ultrasound so increase renal resistive index with obstruction. Severity of delay, nephrogram, excretion, and collecting system drainage. On IVP, contrast entering dilated collecting system by excretion retrograde injection or vesical urethral reflux during VCUG may be very diluted due to mixing with retained urine, plus minus crossing vessel at absorption size. On contrast intensity, on view or the sound, nuclear medicine and renal scan is well established for initial assessment and follow-up of renal function and obstruction. MR urography may provide optimal combination and anatomic and physiologic assessment. This is ultrasound of an infant with prenatal hydronephrosis, so dilated central and peripheral calyces and a large renal pelvis. No ureteral dilatation was seen, and a ureteral pelvic junction obstruction was subsequently diagnosed. Note that hypoechoic renal pyramid are normal in infant. Ultrasound in a 10-day old, so moderate peripheral and central calyces ectasis. with a large renal pelvis that rapidly taper without hydrourethra. Delay post contrast IP in the same patient, so focal narrowing at the UPJ, but without a crossing vessel identified. This case was followed with imaging to monitor for progression with vision resolution. Fluoroscopic imaging during cystoscopy and retrograde urethrography, so a dilated right renal collecting system and abrupt caliber change at the UPJ. MIP from heavily situated MR urography in a 2-month-old, so left worse than right collecting system dilation in a typical configuration of UPJ obstruction. Contrast enhanced CT, so markedly hydronephrosis right kidney with the delay enhancement. On adjacent image, the renal pelvis appear dilated, but no ureter was visualized consistent with UPJ obstruction. Treatment: balloonplasty, open or laparoscopic surgery, taper this member. Balloonplasty has been classic surgery for UPJ obstruction. Narrow segment is resected or crossing vessel is rerouted. Urethral stents are often left in place for several weeks because of open or laparoscopic procedure are preferable when crossing vessel or aberrant vessel are recognized. Endoscopic incision, endobelostomy, endobelloplasty, horizontal percutaneous suturing of conventional longitudinal endobelostomy incision, urethrocolecystostomy, which is a reconstructive option in a rare patient with surgically failed UPJ or difficult anatomy due to fibrosis or other concurrent problem, endourethral balloon plasty staining, percutaneous drainage temporizing if infected. Thank you.